I'm joined by NASA astronaut and naval aviator Victor Glover. Thank you so much for talking with us today.
Yeah, glad to be here, Maury.
You guys do a lot of training, particularly training underwater for walking in space. Absolutely. What is that training like?
Oh, it's amazing. You've got lots of people there to make sure that things are done safely. To put those two people in the suits, you may have 25 to 30 people there. And to put that on, you're really wearing a spacecraft. When you're outside of the space station, you're in a personalized spacecraft. And putting that on can require the help of teammates. So there's a lot of folks there to help make sure that things are done safely. And then we go to work. You start to train to repair things, to use the tools, and to work together and to communicate with your teammates. It's amazing training.
Wow. Do you guys ever use virtual reality to train for spacewalks?
Absolutely. We have a virtual reality lab where they have a system of pulleys and gears and mechanisms set up that you put the virtual reality glasses on and your gloves, and they can grab the handles from something, we call them the machines, the boxes, and you hold on to those and the machine will simulate what something feels like in microgravity. So I can hold on to a 1,700 pound pump module and hold those handles, and I can hold it by myself. But then if I move a little bit, I can feel what it's like to stop that mass, because even in microgravity, things still have mass. So starting and stopping them from moving can be a little unnerving. And we get to sense that using virtual reality. You can see your hands holding the box and feel the weight.
Wow.
It's pretty amazing.
Do you ever train for the really mundane things? Eating, taking a shower, going to the bathroom? Do you have to train for that?
There's no shower. So that you don't train, you don't have to actually train for that one. You wipe down and then you go to work. The crew of the space station, the International Space Station, has six people on it optimally, nominally. And with those six people, you have to be able to perform all of the science. You have to be able to do the spacewalks to keep the station running. You have to be able to work together, and they support public affairs events. They do the maintenance when something breaks. When the toilet breaks, they're the ones that fix it. So you have to be competent in all of those things. Crew members that are experienced talk to us new guys and let us know what things are really like and give us some things to choose from, so we understand what it's like.
Is that an important part of the training, is talking to people that have been there and done that?
Absolutely. You know, the folks that train us, they've got the great degrees, they've been at NASA for a very long time, but there's only a small cadre of folks that have actually been there and taken all of that training and put it into practice. And so that's the folks that have been in our office for a while, and so we lean very heavily on their experience.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for talking with us today.
My pleasure, Marty.